Hi everyone, today we're gonna make strawberries in Blender 2.81. So let's begin. The first thing we need to do just one moment. You don't need to follow the step because it's already on. So the first thing we need to do is to select this cube and delete it by pressing X and delete. Now I'm going to the front view by pressing 1 and add a UV sphere that is the base of our strawberry. So let's press Shift A, UV sphere, mesh, UV sphere. And now you can see this little menu here. Let's open it. And for this purpose, we're going to use 15 segments and 15 rings. If I'm not wrong, a strawberry has like 5 centimeters. So let's type 5 cm, enter. And to zoom in or zoom out, you just press the middle mouse of your middle button of your mouse. That's all. Okay, we don't need this menu anymore. Now, let's go to edit mode by pressing tab. Now, face, poke faces. And as you can see here, we are in vertex select mode. And I want to select those edges, and so we need to change from vertex select to edge select. And let's deselect this UV sphere by pressing Alt A. And now you just click, but I want all those. So you hold shift and select the others. Now I want all that are similar selected. Then select similar face angle. I want those selected. So select invert. And now I'm gonna delete them by pressing X, and I just want to delete the edges. And now we have this. Okay, and as you can see, we don't have any faces, so let's create it by pressing A to select and F to create the face. Okay. Sorry about that. So now you have a hotkey for this for what we're gonna do now. The hotkey is I, or you can go here, face, insert faces, then you click and press enter. When you press enter, you can see this menu here. In this menu, you select individual, and then the thickness, and I think 0.002 is fine, and the depth a negative value, so minus 0.001 is okay. Now I want to resize those selected areas, but if I try now by pressing S, look, it doesn't work. So I need to change from medium point to individual origin. And now I can press S and resize them. I think that let me see, like this is fine. Now we press E, ESC, S, okay, and now we need to give some depth to it. So again, let's change from medium, from individual origins to medium point, and let's press S. I think it's pretty good. And we are going to use those selected areas in particle system later, so we need to create a group for it to assign in the particle system later. So here in this little green icon you selected, and here in vertex groups you press this plus button to add a new vertex group. Let's rename it to seeds, and let's assign. Now I'm gonna see if it worked. So deselect, select, that's fine. Okay, now we have this group. Okay, now it's time for us to save our work. So here in file, save as, I'm going to name mine strawberry. You type strawberry or any name you want, and save as. Now let's create the seed, and for this we're gonna need a icosphere. So I want this icosphere here, and the new objects are add where the cursor is. The cursor is this little white and red thing, and to change the location of the cursor, it's a little bit different from the other versions, from the .9 by example, that you just needed to click. Now we come here in this cursor and click where you want it, and now we go back to this, because if this is selected you cannot click in any object. So let's go back to this select box. And now, let's add the icosphere by pressing Shift A, Mesh, Icosphere, and let's resize it. Scale down by pressing S, to zoom in or zoom out, you need the middle mouse button. Okay, and now S, X, and as you can see, those faces are visible and we don't want that. So let's click right button, shade smoothing, fine. And as you can see, we scale it. So let's apply the scale by pressing Ctrl A, scale. Okay, and this sphere doesn't look nothing like a strawberry. So we need to add a subsurf modifier that looks like a smooth. So let's select our strawberry, and here in this icon, let's add subdivision surface level 2. Okay, and right mouse, shade smooth, and let's save our job. File, save. Okay, now let's add the seeds to this strawberry. So here in this icon that looks like a chicken foot, we hit plus button only once and let's rename it to seed. Also here, seed. Let's change from emitter to hair, and now we need to see how many seeds we're gonna need here in this number. So here we go to the edit mode by pressing tab. In my case, it's already selected, and here, down here, you can see that we have 2612 vertices, the whole strawberry, and selected we have 435. So here we need 435. Okay, we can go back to the object mode by pressing tab. And here we are gonna select that vertex group that we created. So seed, and here inserts. We don't need faces, we need verts. Okay, and let's deselect, uncheck this random order. Fine. And here in render, instead of path, our seed is an object. So let's select here, and with this eyedropper you can select the seed, and it's done. Let's rename some objects in the scene. As you can see here in this yellow square, you can see that the name of this object is sphere. But now we have strawberry, so let's rename it by to strawberry. And if you select the seed, you can see it's icosphere, so let's rename it to seed. Okay, let's go to the front view by pressing 1, and as as you can see, we don't have a strawberry shape, we have a sphere shape. So let's make this strawberry shape. And for that, we're going to use the proportional editing. So let's go to the edit mode by pressing tab. And as you can see, our vertices are still selected. So let's deselect them by pressing Alt A. Okay. And now to rotate your scene, you press the middle button mouse button. You press, hold, and rotate. So down, let's select this, vert, go to the front view by pressing 1. The proportional editing is here, you can simply click or the hotkey is O to turn on or turn off. Okay, now to move you press G. But take a look, it's moving the whole object. It's because the affected area is too big, so we need to resize this proportional editing. So you press G and roll the middle mouse button to make it smaller. Look, you just roll. See? And look, this size is okay for me. So again, G, and I wanted to move only in the Z axis. So G, Z. G, Z. Okay. And now deselect it by pressing Alt A, rotate it, select this, go to the front view by pressing 1, and again G, Z, down. I think it's fine. So let's save it. File, save. Now let's create the leaves. Let's go to the front view by pressing 1. And for the leaves, I'm going to use a circle. Let's add it by press Shift A, or if you want you can just go here, add mesh circle, and here in vertices we're gonna need 40 vertices for this, because I need like 5 leaves, and every leaf has 8 vertices. This is the reason why I decided to use 40 vertices. So let's go to the front view by pressing 1, resize it by pressing S, and let's bring it to the strawberry by pressing G, X, G, Z, G, X. Let's go to the top view to see if it's okay in all views by pressing 7, and G, Y, We need to put it in the center so it's fine. So let's go back to the front view by pressing 1 and resize it again by pressing S. I think this is fine. So let's go to the top view again by pressing 7. I think it's fine. So now we're going to the edit mode by pressing Tab, deselect it all by pressing Alt+A, and select 8 vertices. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's duplicate it, these 8 vertices, by pressing Shift D and Esc. But now this duplication is part of the same mesh, is still part of the same mesh, so we need to separate these 8 vertices from the other mesh, and to do that we press Ctrl P, sorry, P and separate the selection. Okay, now we have these two meshes. This is one, this is other. So now from these vertices we're gonna create our first leaf. So side view by pressing 3, edit mode by pressing Tab. Now let's select all by pressing A. And now let's turn this proportional edit off by pressing O. And now let's start making our leaf. E. E. I think it's fine. Let's go to the top view. Yes. Now let's turn the proportional editing again by pressing O. Now S, X. Let's make a little bit smaller. To select a loop, you press Alt and click with the right button. With left button, sorry. And S, X. I am used to the old version of Blender, so sometimes I think it's the older way. Okay, now we have a leaf. But we have only one leaf and we need leaves. We need like 5 leaves. So here it's okay. To do that, we are going to use a array and a empty to put those leaves in this circle. So we need the cursor in the center of this circle. So let's select the circle, press Shift S, cursor to select, and you can see the cursor is in the center. Now we add the empty by pressing Shift A, empty plane axis. Okay, fine. And now let's select the leaf and I think in my case my cursor, my origin point, this little yellow circle, I think, is already there. But if it's not, you select the leaf and right mouse button, set origin to 3D cursor, and it's okay. So now let's add the array modifier. Here, add modifier array. Array, and we don't want relative offset, we want object offset, because we are going to use this empty to rotate. So we unchecked here, because here if you keep increasing the number, take a look, you can choose the axis here, but that's not what we want. So we unchecked, checked here, and with the eyedropper we select the empty. Okay. So let's go to the top view by pressing 7. Select the empty RZ. Oh, let me see something. I think we need to apply the scale by pressing Ctrl A, scale. Let me see now. Okay, so let's go to the top view, RZ. Let's select the leaves and increase this value to, oh, it's 6. And now let's hide our strawberry, this way we can see the leaves better. So select the strawberry and press H. Now select the leaves, go to the wireframe mode by pressing Z. Select the array, the empty, and RZ. I think it's fine. Now let's unhide the strawberry by pressing Alt H. Okay. And let's go back to the solid view by pressing Z6. And let's save it, of course. I save. Let's select the leaf. Right button. Shade. Smooth. And also let's add a subdivision surface, because in my opinion those leaves are very like squarish. So add modifier subdivision surface. Now we need to finish it. So let's select the circle, go to the top view, go to the edit mode, you switch from object mode to edit mode just by pressing tab. So here we are in the edit mode, so let's select it by pressing A. Now extrude it by pressing E, ESC, S. Oh, and we need to turn off the proportional editing by pressing O, so. S, again, E, ESC, S, E, ESC, S, and one more time, E, ESC, S. Now we go to the front view by pressing 1. Let's hide those leaves Let's go to the object mode by pressing tab, select the leaves, H to hide them, and select our circle, and let's go to edit mode, front view, E, Z. Let's go back to the object mode. Let's deselect it by pressing Alt A and select this loop here by pressing Alt and click. Yes, but it's not this look that we want. We want that. Now let's unhide our leaves by pressing Alt H. Okay. Now select the leaves. Hold Shift, select this center part. Let's go to the front view by pressing 1 and bring it down a little, so G, Z. Oh, I forgot, I have to add the array modifier to apply the array modifier first. So let's select the leaves and apply the array. So now we select the leaves, hold Shift, the middle, go to front, and G, Z to bring it down. Okay, fine. And now as you can see, all the leaves are exactly the same, and we are modeling something organic, so it's almost impossible. So let's randomize them. Select the leaves, go to the edit mode by pressing tab, and let's turn on the proportional editing by pressing O, and now you can select and G, make it a little bit different. G, now we can delete this empty by selecting it, X, delete. Okay, but I need these leaves need to be a little bit bigger, so let's select this part, hold Shift, this, S, much better. Now it's time to create the materials, so let's bring this window up. When you see this arrow, you just drag it. And here, let's select Shader Editor, and let's split this window in two. Here, when you see this arrow, you right click and you see vertical split, and you click. Now to make this and this disappear, press N, and okay, now we have two windows. One to shader and another UV editor. Okay, so now let's unwrap our strawberry. Let's go to the front view by pressing 1. Select the strawberry. Go to the edit mode by pressing tab. Selecting all the object by pressing A. Now let's go, let's press U, project from view. And now you can see we have here our model unwrapped. So let's press A, S, and make it a little bit bigger. Okay. It's unwrapped. So now let's create our lights. So let's go to the front view by pressing 1, and I'm going to use a area lamp for this purpose. In Blender you have a lot of options of light. If you press Shift A, here in light you have point, sun, spot, and area. But I prefer create my own light by pressing Shift A, mesh, plane. Let's resize it by pressing S, bring it to up by pressing G, Z, and rotate it in the Y axis by pressing R, Y, and bring it to the side by pressing G, X. Okay, and now we are going to create this material. But first, let me see, you can see this lamp here. So let's delete it. You just select it and press X, delete. So let's go again to the front view by pressing 1. Select this, and here in this material properties, let's create the lamp. New, let's rename it to light, and here in the shader editor, you click in this principal BSDF X. Oh, we deleted all. So, Ctrl Z. And let's deselect it first by pressing Alt A. And now select this and X. Okay. To make this light, we're gonna use a emission. So let's add it by pressing Shift A, shader, emission, and let's plug it here. So let's go to the render view to see our illumination. Here, render view. Oh, another thing, I am doing this tutorial in Cycles, but we're still in Eevee. You can create in Eevee because materials are the same. So here in this little like television, you change from Eevee to Cycles. Okay, and the strength, let's use 5. Okay. And now we need to duplicate this light source by pressing Shift D, G, X, R, Y. And bring it a little bit down by pressing G, Z. Okay. But now we have two objects, two lights, but only one material. And we need different strengths for each one of them. So here in material, we have this light. If you hit this number two here, now we have two materials. This one, that is light. And this one that is light 0.0001. 001. You can rename it if you want, but I'm gonna leave like this. So let's go to the front view. And for this one, we're going to use a strength of 2. Fine. And also, let's add a spot light by pressing Shift A, light, spot, and let's rotate it by pressing R, X, minus 90, and bring it to back by pressing G, Y, and resize it by pressing S. Okay. Let's save it, now it's time. File. Save. Okay, now let's select our strawberry. And here we need a color palette. You really don't need it, but I think it's easier. So let's open it. This color palette. Let's go. By the way, I am using the mouse to paint. I have a pen tablet, but I am going to use the mouse. This way you can see that it's possible. So, let's change from object mode to texture paint. And here let's create our image. Here in image, new, let's rename it to strawberry scan. And 2048. 2048. We don't need alpha, so let's uncheck it. Okay. Okay. Now here you have it. So let's create the strawberry material. I am already in material place here. So let's hit new. Rename it to strawberry. And here, Shift A, texture, image, texture, and let's select this strawberry skin, and plug it color to the base color. Okay. Now we are going to start to paint. So let's select the palette again. And let's start with this red color. So let's go to the solid view here. And here, select the eyedropper and the red. Now we can fill it with this bucket. So let's again take the red and click. Okay, now our whole strawberry is red. And so now let's go back to the draw mode here. Select with the eyedropper this shade of red down the strength to like 0.4022 is 5, and paint. Rotate it with the middle mouse button. Okay, and over here we're going to use this yellow color that is here. It's very clear. Sometimes you cannot see it, but let's use it. So select here, eyedropper, and here, and the strength to like 252, and let's paint here. Okay, I think it's fine. So let's see. Let's save it now. Let's switch from palette to strawberry skin. And image, save as image. And now let's see in the render view how it is. Pretty amazing, right? So now let's go to the object mode and start working with the material. Okay, now here, we don't need this for now. So here you can see it looks like plastic, and a strawberry skin, and the sunlight is able to cross through it, so we need to simulate this with the subsurface scattering. So here in subsurface, let's test it. You can see it's a very weird result because the subsurface color is white, so we need to use our image and plug to the subsurface color. Okay, and let's see, I think okay, but the roughness down to 232. Okay, in my opinion it's okay. So now let's make the material for the seed. So select the seed. And here in material, new, seeds, and the seed material is easy, I think. You just need to select like color like this. And same color, subsurface. Not too much. You can play here with it. But I think it's okay. Now it's time to make the material for the leaves. So let's select the leaves. And let's join this leaf with this part. So you select the leaves, hold shift, select this part, control J, and now we have only one. So let's go to the edit mode by pressing tab, press the whole leaves by pressing A, go to the top view by pressing 7, U, project from view, and let's scale it by pressing A, S, G to move it. Okay, and now we need to create another. So I'm not sure if we saved this. Yes, we did. So let's create another one. New leaf. And okay. Now here material, let's add a new. Rename it to leaf, and here shift A, image, where is image, texture, image texture, and select here the leaf, okay, and plug it to here. So now let's go to the solid view and start painting in the paint mode here. Texture paint. And now we need our palette again. So let's select it. Let's select it here. Here this fill and eyedropper, this shade of green, and click. Okay, everything is with only one color. Okay, and now here with this draw brush selected and in texture paint mode, let's eyedrop this color and make it darker like this, and I think about 500 is okay. And let's paint here. Here it's fine. think it's okay, so let's work in the material now. Let's save. Here you select the leaf and image, save as leaf, save as image, and here in this render mode you can see it. So let's work with the material. Shift A, shader, add shader, Shift A, shader, translucent, BSTF, and this color plug to this. And let's position our camera now. I think it's the time. So press 1. If you press Ctrl Alt 0, the camera goes to the view that you are. So Ctrl Alt 0. You can see that now we have our camera here. Okay, now it's time to make our ball. So let's place our ball here. To go here, you just press Shift and the middle mouse. And let's place our cursor here because it's here where we want our UV sphere to be placed. So let's select the cursor, click here, go back to the select box, press Shift A, mesh UV sphere, and it is still with our last segments and rings. So in this case I need 32 segments and 16 rings. Okay, so let's go to the edit mode by pressing tab, deselect it by pressing Alt A, go to the wireframe view by pressing Z4, and now box select the upper part, B, and select this part. Oh. And now we are going to delete this upper part by pressing X, vertices. Now go to the object mode by pressing tab, and go to the front view, and let's make it a little bit smaller in the z-axis. So S, Z, I think it's okay. Let's go to the solid view by pressing Z6, and shade smooth with the right mouse. Shade smooth. Okay. And let's see the size now in relation to the strawberry. So G, X. Now let's go to the front view by pressing 1. And G, Z. S, S, like this, And now our ball is too thin and we need some thickness here in this modifier. Let's go to the solidify modifier and let's apply the scale by pressing Ctrl A scale. Okay. And here in thickness, let me see. I think 0.02 is fine. Now let's add the subdivision surface. Okay. Level 2. Awesome. So let's go to the camera view by pressing 0. I think, GZ. I think it is still big. So S and resize it. GX. Okay. Let's go to the render view. I want this ball to have a ceramic material. So let's make it now. Here, let's go to the material panel here, new ceramic, and it's very easy. Here we just need to play with the roughness material. That's it. Now let's place our camera. Press 0, select the camera, bring it up by pressing GZ, and let's rotate it in the X-axis by pressing RX, like this, and bring it to GZ. Okay, nice. But I think those lights need to be in front of it, so let's select them. Select one, hold shift, select other, G, Y. Now select this, R, Z. So let's bring these lights here by pressing G, Y. I'll select the light, shift select the other. G, Y. Now select this, R, Z. And this, R, Z. And as they are far from our object, we need to make the strength bigger. So here, let's try 10 and 5. I think it's fine, but we need more strawberries now, and with different shapes. So let's go to the solid view and We can hide all those things for now to make the strawberry. So select the camera, shift, select the light and press H. Okay. So I select the strawberry. Go to the front view. Shift B, G, X. Now to change the shape of the strawberry, we are going to use the fall off and the proportional editing. So select your strawberry, go to edit view by pressing shift, select anywhere you want. Mine is already on, but if yours not, just press O and G. I think I'm going to use 3 strawberries. Do the same thing. Make it a little bit smaller by pressing S. Okay, and now we need to put them in this bowl. So let's bring it down by pressing G, Z. R X G Z. GY, GX, and now this one, GX, GZ, GY, and GZ. Let's see now in the camera view by pressing 0. I want it to be centered, so I'm going to press B and select all of them. Now G, X, and I can bring them to the center. Now let's bring the light and the camera to the scene again to unhide them by pressing Alt H. And let's see here in the render view. Pretty nice. So as you can see, this strawberry and this, you can see that at least the texture is exactly the same. So we are going to select it and rotate it in the Z axis. Now you can see they are a little bit different. So let's save it, file save. And now the last step is to create like a table or a wood material where this ball is on it. So let's create it now. Let's press Shift A, plane. As you can see, our plane is there. So GX. Go to the camera view again by pressing 0. Now GZ. We can go to the side view to see if they don't touch. So GZ. Again to the camera view by pressing 0. Okay, and let's bring it a little bit to the back by pressing GY. Okay. And now let's unwrap it. Let's go to the top view. Tab to the edit mode U, and here you can just unwrap our project from view. So project from view. And let's create our material here. Material new, and I'm going to rename my like hood. Okay. Now for the wood texture, we are going to use this wonderful, amazing site called HDRI Heaven that helped me a lot. All the textures in this site, textures and HDRIs, are CC0, the license. So, and they are very professional and I just love it. So, just to show you, we are going to use the textures from this site. So let's go back to Blender. And here we already have our wood material. And let's select Shift A, texture, image, texture. Open this texture and color to the color. And now here let's select this wood material AS. But it's in the wrong direction, so let's press R and rotate it. You can press Ctrl to help you. And let's disable this proportional editing by pressing O. Okay. And I want my planks to be bigger. So let's press S and okay, fine. Now here let's add another texture, image texture, and let's select the roughness value. In the color space let's select none color. The only image texture that you need the color is diffuse or albedo. All the other ones are non-color. Take a look, this is sRGB. You can also use Filmic. I think I prefer Filmic. So, and here non-color, and plug the color to the roughness. Okay, and now we just duplicate it by pressing Shift D And now we open this purple texture. That is the normal texture, non-color. And shift A, vector, normal map. Look the color to here, and the normal to normal. Let me experiment a bit. I think 2 is okay. So that's it. Now we just need to render our strawberries. To render, you go to this window. I'm going to render with 200 samples. You can render, I always render with 500 or more, but only for this tutorial I'm going to use 200. And also here you choose 100%. I think that's it, and you press F12. And it's done. Now you just save your image, save as, and I'm going to save mine as T of the strawberry and save image. And let's make one last test, so let's close it and see how it is in Eevee. So here in this little television, instead of cycles, you select Eevee. Look, the strawberries are still acceptable, but this. The ceramic material is odd. So I think that's it. I hope you like it. And thank you.